Aber wie war es auch hier geglaubt? Let's get started. Webster's Dictionary defines wedding as the process of removing weeds from one's garden. That's not right. Let's skip weddings. I'll move on to marriage. Maybe we'll circle back. Let's start with marriage. We all know or have ideas of what marriage is. We've been doing it for millennia. It is the grand tradition of commitment and love. Of relationships, it is our highest state, achieved only when two people are truly devoted to each other. For you, it is the final great leap in your journey of love begun over 7 years ago. To say you are married is to say, this is set in stone, this is steadfast. We have tied the knot and are bound to one another. But marriage also isn't really any of these things. I just rattled off a bunch of common metaphors that we use to talk about marriage. They sort of inform our idea of what marriage is, you know, ought to be, but they also miss the mark. I get why we do this. We're trying to pin down the concept of marriage, so we can point at it and say, that's what it is, and hopefully give us some idea of what we're giving ourselves into. But in trying to say what marriage is, we limit what marriage can be. I propose that marriage is a mystery, one of the great mysteries of life. It is full of paradoxes, unknowns, and revelations. For your consideration, allow me to contradict everything I just said about marriage, so I can suggest the potentialities your marriage holds for you. Yes, potentialities. I own a thesaurus. While marriage is one of our oldest traditions, it doesn't look the same as it did just a few generations ago, let alone millennia. Yours will be unique still among them all. It is not a rational relational state to be achieved. For it is not static. I believe that it is alive and evolves, just as we grow and change our daily lives. Your status as married will not be a status quo. Think of it not as set in stone, for it's not some tomb or beautiful mausoleum where your love resides. Think of it more as a fire that you feed and tend to each day. Hopefully your marriage is not a circumstance you have found yourself in where you are bound to one another. So much as you are drawn to one another, and the fire, the warmth of that fire, and the fire. Lastly, consider marriage not as a destination that you arrive at, but an expedition to places yet undiscovered. Which brings us back to today, your wedding. It might be the last step in the process you started way back when. But it might also be just the beginning. You're here at the precipice of the unknown, beyond, only frontier, and a lot of group photos. And baby. But I invite you to raise that mystery. I started off by quoting Homer Simpson, reading the wrong definition of wedding. And that was not only an excellent icebreaker, but also it beautifully sums up the following trend of divine with something that you two need to decide from the beginning. So now, for those in attendance, I'd like to remind you that Mark and Ange present themselves to be married today, cheerfully and surrounded by the people they love. They and I want to thank you for your presence here today. It is your presence that lends true significance to the ceremony, and they ask for your encouragement and lifelong support. We're all here to welcome you two across the finish line, but more importantly, to see you off on your voyage. While there's no map to, for where to go next, your vows will help you chart course. Speaking of vows, the couple did already exchange some special vows in private, but because that's no fun for us, and it's been scientifically proven that vows just hit different in front of an audience of well-dressed loved ones who also share some of them at this time.
I'm Mark, taking you to Angeline to be my wife and the best friend and partner. In all of life's circumstances, good or bad, I vow to stand by you and support you, to be patient and gentle with you. I vow to keep your best interests at heart and my intentions pure. I vow to continue to grow as a parent with you, to set the best example for Miles and our future children, to model kindness and respect for others, and above all, to show them how to be a loving husband. And most importantly, I vow to always fill up your your Stanley every night to make sure your slippers are next to our side of the bed.
Accept this act of love and commitment and take Mark to your husband?
I do.
Let's run that back for you. Let's run it back. Angelina, repeat it after me. With this ring?
With this ring.
I commit my life to yours.
I commit my life to yours.
Yours. Mark, do you accept this act of commitment and take Angelina to your wife?
I do.
Well, with no further ado, with the power vested in me by the great state of California, I now pronounce you Mr. and Mrs. Diaco. You may take care of yourself.